Hey guys, what's happening there? I'm here in Rigo, Quebec here, just west of the island of Montreal, near the Ontario border. And I'm here to show you guys the old Rigo, former AMTCP train station. For those who don't know, the Rigo station, this was an important station back in the day. This station opened up in 1889 and ended in June 2010. And this station, this would literally connect back then. This was known as the M&O subdivision. It would literally connect Ontario all the way to Montreal. This was an important line, man. A very important line back in the day. Because back then, there were farmers and everything. Farms and fields. And you would have people take the train. It was almost as if it was like a via rail service, you know? People would go see family or people would go to their jobs in Montreal, you know? And the main reason why, like, they closed the station is for two main reasons. One, the service, the ridership was low. And two, the town had to pay $158,000 for that one train that would leave at 6:40 and come back here at 7 p.m. every day, man. You know? And, like, I mean, back then, I think, like, maybe back then in 2010, 10 years ago, they could have had, like, it was probably the best decision they made. But now, with all the houses being built and everything, with the young population wanting to get to Montreal, this could have been, like, you know, the gateway to the city, you know? They could have increased service, had more trains, you know? And yeah, you know? And the history of the station is that the station, the building itself, this was built in... It was built in 1889, but then after that, it was reconstructed in the 40s into this because of the, because back then it was a wood structure, not a stone. And that garage door, by the way, that wasn't there before. That actually used to be a wood door, just like all these doors, you know? And I've seen pictures of this station for, back in the day, and it's so beautiful. There's this one picture in the winter in 89 or something. So beautiful, the station in the winter at night. You have all these beautiful lights lighting up, you know. Yeah. And, you know, and I remember as a kid, like, I was with my grandmother, and, like, we were at the Benny Library in NDG, and I was looking at the newspaper, and I see the train ending to Rigo, and I'm like, oh no, you know, like, I wish I took it, you know. But hey, and unfortunately the building is starting to decay. Look at this, look at the roof, it's already deteriorating, you know. People have probably smashed into those windows I don't know how many times. It's a shame right there that iconic Rigo sign is gone, man. Like, I have a feeling that it might have, is most likely had fallen down, because the nut, the screws are still there, so it must have fallen down because it was a wood sign, you know. Yeah, now, like, the train ends at Hudson, you know, and then, like, it would literally take almost half an hour between here and Hudson because the tracks, they're starting to become unstable because they were so old and all that, you know. I think that's the 40 over there, the Highway 40, Trans-Canada there. And the one thing that's almost like that's left from the AMT that they never took down was those speakers. Those speakers were probably never taken down, man. They're probably never, if ever, used because it was one train. And I don't think they ever used them because the train was always on time, you know? Now this, I have no idea what the hell this is. But yeah, you know, like, it's just incredible, you know? Of how a station like this in such a small town shut down after 111 years, man. 111 years. And then I don't know what's going to happen with Hudson very soon. Because Hudson, I mean, their service is at least a bit better than Rigo. But if the town can't afford it, then they're going to have to close it, and then everyone's going to have to go all the way to Vaudreuil, you know, where the service is like fire, you know? And I can imagine a train right here, man. Like one of the old, the go-karts, the ex-go-karts, either the double-deckers, Canadian Vickers, or the Bombardier ones. I can imagine it just right here. Yeah, I just hope one day the town of Rigo thinks either they can bring this service back or at least reuse the structure, at least. Because this structure is it's like almost as if it's like a heritage site. It probably most likely is, you know? You know, one station that I kind of think of like this is Kanziak. But Kanziak is a wave. It's because, you know, like the service is very low on that line, but at least the ridership is always up. It's you know, it's all right there. But here, no. All right, so that's it, guys. The Rigo train station. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for more videos to come, and I'll show you some photos of the Rigo station back in the day and the photos I've took. Thank you.
I'm standing in the station. I am waiting for a train to take me to the border. I'm my loved one far away. I watched a bunch of soldiers heading for the war. I could hardly even bear to see them go. Rolling through the countryside, tears are in my eyes. We're coming to the borderline. I'm ready with my life. And in the early morning rain, I see her there. And I know I'll have to say goodbye again. See the wisdom.